So there we go, Porsche headquarters, right there. That's the corporate office. That's the hotel. One Porsche Drive, and here's the main gate. The restaurant just called and said, your name has been given to the front gate. You're welcome to come early. So this starts the 356 restaurant experience. So if you come and do their racing, that is the hotel that you would stay at, right there. And the museum and the restaurant and everything is right over here on the left. I'm gonna put the camera down here for a second and give them my name and get through the gate here. All right, here we go. Now, I think visitor parking is level one downstairs, but last time I was here, I just parked right over here and nobody seemed to mind. We've got a whole bunch of charging stations right all the way down there. Just go ahead and park here. So you get a 356 wristband that I hope you're allowed to keep. Guess where I am? Say hi, Bill. Oh, here, I'll give you a tip. Up, got the camera, 356. Oh my goodness. Right there, yep. Porsche headquarters. So this is pretty cool. I didn't film this last time I was here, but it's basically a model of the entire property. This right here, I'll do my best to, this is where we drove in. So that's the guard booth right there. And then we came around and we parked right here. Those charging stations are all right here, and that's the entrance that we went in, right there. When we were filming the track, we were standing right here, which is at the end of the cafe. So here's the way the building looks. They didn't do the hotel. I guess it wasn't built yet when they made this model, but here's where the hotel is. And then the track is actually pretty long. This is the wet part where that Targa was doing donuts. This water retention looks like it's just, you know, water retention for the property. When you see the cars go down and make a left down there, they're really just doing this little loop close to the freeway. And then here's the off-road track, which you can't really see from the building. But that's what the whole property looks like. And where we are is we're in the museum, looking at all of the old catalogs and manuals and magazines and all the old neat stuff that they keep here in the museum. And this is the first level of the museum. We're gonna go downstairs right there in a minute.
Perfect.
So nice. I was headed to town, and here's a quick what they start with, and then they stamp it, polish it, paint it some more, a final. It's a lot of, and then here they explain everything that goes into the emblem. So we're downstairs in the museum. They've got totally different cars. They must change this up all the time. These red ones were here last time I was here, but these were not, so that's gonna be a treat over there. But here's some race cars. And then the thing I love about these is they're not restored. There's little swirls and scratches. You can see the paint color is slightly different between the plastic and the aluminum. This is just what you would get if your car was this old and you took care of it. You know, so often you see cars in museums that have been restored. I just love it that they're not restored.
You know, this just fuels your addiction, right?
Yeah.
Things worse.
Yeah.
What are you seeing there?
Pretty much the brain, but I'm looking.
So, Carrera GT, just ridiculous. Absolute ridiculous beauty. Something about a silver car.
Yeah,
I really can't imagine what it's like to drive one of these. Not a lot of computer assistance. Maybe none. I'm not sure. I do know that they are squirrely. Some people think they're dangerous, but you can't argue that they're beautiful. Here's a quick view into the shop. They've got a Carrera GT back in there. They've got a little yellow 911. Can't tell what that is. And then a 914 in there they're working on. And let's head up to the restaurant.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes. Is that obvious?
Yes.
It is.
Okay, we made it. We made it up to the second floor. This is where the restaurant is, right here, 356. They give you a cool wristband that I showed you before, what we'll do is I'll try to show you as much of the experience here at the restaurant as I can. The menu, the food, the view. So far the experience has been great. We were on our way here, they called us and said, you know, hey, just wanna make sure that you're gonna be on time and confirming your reservation. And we said, you know, we gotta catch a flight. So could we move the reservation up a bit? And they said, yep, absolutely. We open at 11:30, just come on by and we'll get you in. So far so good. Stay tuned. Okay, awesome, thank you. Nice view of the track. Beautiful restaurant, cool bar. There's an entrance over there. So this course is actually pretty cool. What happens is those two yellow things kick the back end of the car out right there. And so that is an example of not having stability control on. Well, here's the menu, and you've got, you know, your wines and more wine and cocktails. It's a full bar. I got some starters on here. Carrot salad, oysters, some main choices here. Try to get the glare off, but right here, Wiener Schnitzel. I mean, I don't see how you could come to a German car manufacturer and not give something German. They said the burger is incredible. They've got some steaks on the menu, but that's it. We're doing the Wiener Schnitzel. Oh, so that was the driver. That was pretty good. Getting a little better. Oh. So both drivers got better after like three passes. So we just got some upgraded utensil here for our wiener schnitzel. It's pretty nice. And the rolls have arrived. Oh, look at that. I didn't notice that before, but the main event here is the little butters and a little flaky salt. Very impressive. You can never have too much butter.
Yeah, mine's burst.
That's awesome.
That's pretty good.
So here we have our wiener schnitzel. Looks like we've got some capers going on in there, some little potato salad on top. It's a pounded piece of pork that's been fried with some spätzle, I'm sure I'm saying that wrong, underneath. You don't get much more German than that. All right, so this is what this experience is like. This is like a land tartar sauce. I think you should probably take a little of everything. So some of the noodle, a little bit of this land tartar sauce, and those weren't capers. There are big chunks of pickles in there, and some of the meat. Very good. It's very good. I didn't squeeze any lemon on it. So let's try some of that. And normally I'm not a big fan of German potato salad because it doesn't really have a lot of mayo in it and it's generally served warm, but I'll try that next. Very good. It's like a fried veal cutlet or pork cutlet. Here it goes for the little bit of potato salad on top. Now, surprisingly, that's cold. It's very tasty. You can taste the vinegar in it. So it is a little bit more traditional German style, being that it has more vinegar than mayo. But the fact that it's cold is really surprising because normally a German potato salad would be warm. But I'd say A+. This dish was $33. And totally worth the experience, but I'd give it a very good, tastes very good. Okay, well, meal's over, check came, and they give you a little pen. Isn't that nice? And the server actually said, "Careful, they write fast." It's pretty funny. All about the experience. All right, well, there you go. That's what dining in the 356 restaurant at the Porsche headquarters in Atlanta looks like, feels like. It was good. I would totally do it again. I love this emblem right here. I actually have a t-shirt that has the 9/11 silhouette on it. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I'll show you a few more clips here of the facility. And as always, appreciate you watching, and I'll see you next time. See ya. A few more clips. Here's the employee lounge. Got a bunch of folks on break in there, enjoying their lunch break. Pretty darn nice place to eat for a corporate office. And here we've got some offices, cubes. We've got some lovely ladies working on something. Very important, I'm sure. And where we are is up on the second floor. There's the stairs we took up to the restaurant. Here's the cars that we saw when we came in. Oh, look, they already swapped them out. How do you like that?
Yeah.
While we were eating, got some new cars. Here's our buddy Ferdinand. And this just kind of wraps around a couple seating areas and more office space over here. And this is as high as you can go in this building. Everything else is pretty much locked off. Back here in the corner, if I remember correctly from last time I was here, is they're like a meeting room for their, you know, conferences or whatever. They do corporate events here. That's where we came from. Right over there, second floor, was the restaurant.
Is it one of the racing ones, or is this just
a... No, I think it's just a regular GT3. Yep, stick shift. And see how the new dash, they only have one dial now. Everything else is a screen. I just personally prefer the
gauges.
Then the, this thing is just intense. Yeah, the rim looks like a Tron, like they should light up, you know?
Neon colors.